Hi everyone, and welcome to the next lesson in this series on AWS Fundamentals. So today I'll be teaching you how to enable MFA, which stands for Multi-Factor Authentication, on your AWS accounts. Okay, so we are currently logged into our IAM user. Now let's go to IAM, and I just want to explain something here. So let's go here. Okay, and you'll notice this message comes up, the security recommendation, as we can see here, the add MFA for yourself. Now, you'll have noticed that when you first logged into IAM, so in other words, when you were creating your first IAM user for the first time, you had to use your root user for the first time. And you will have noticed that it gave you the option there to add MFA for your root user as well. So it looks exactly the same here, this dashboard, okay? But what earlier on you would have seen is add MFA for your root user. And now in this case, as we're signed in as an IAM user, okay, we also have the option here to add MFA, okay? So in AWS, okay, it's good practice to go ahead and add multi-factor authentication to both your accounts. So make sure that you add MFA for your IAM user account, okay, and for your root account. So for the root account, what you would have to do then is you would have to log out and then also go ahead and add multi-factor authentication. Now, the way of doing it is going to be the same. So I'm going to teach you how you would go ahead and add multi-factor authentication. Okay, so be sure after you set it here for your IAM user, okay, to log out, go to your root account, and just make sure that you add multi-factor authentication to your root account. Very, very important, okay? So just be sure you do that. But the ways to do it is going to be the same, okay? So don't worry. So let me demonstrate how you would do it. So whether we're in the IAM user account or the root user account, we can go ahead and say add MFA. Okay, so it'll open a new tab for us here. So let's just wait for it to load. Okay, and we can go ahead and just scroll down. Okay, you can scroll down. And here it's going to say assign MFA device, okay? So go ahead and click on that. And we get three different options here. We can choose to select a virtual MFA device. So this is an authenticator app that can be installed on our mobile device or our computer. And in some cases, it's going to be on the computer and the mobile device. And in other cases, it's just going to be on the mobile device. Then you can also go ahead and choose a security key. So this would be hardware based or another token, another method, which is via a Gemalto token. So you can hit continue. Okay, now what you can do, you can open this here, this link in another tab. Okay, and it's just going to explain a little bit about MFA for IAM. If you want some more information about it, you can go ahead and read here, where it talks about security keys, virtual authenticator apps, hardware tokens, and so on. So you can go ahead and read this. Something important that I want to mention here when you choose your virtual authenticator app. So I would strongly recommend that you utilize AllC Authenticator here. Okay, whether you're on iOS or Android, it's available. So I'd suggest you use this one. Now, I know a common one to use is Google Authenticator, and that's not a problem. That's perfectly fine. But I would strongly recommend you use AllC. Okay, that is much better. It's much safer. It also does regular backups on your, for example, on your AllC Authenticator as well. So I would suggest this one. The only difference here was the AllC Authenticator one is you're going to set it up for the first, you're going to set it up also on your computer and on your phone, and it's going to sort of sync together. Okay, so I'd highly recommend that you install the AllC app. Okay, so that's just what I wanted to mention. Now, what you'll do typically is you'll get your Authenticator app ready to go, and then you're going to show your QR code. So you'll click on here, it will reveal a QR code. And then you're going to, of course, scan this with your Authenticator app, and then you're going to get your first MFA code. Okay, so you know that code that generates, and then you'll have, for example, a timer before it expires. So the way to set it up in AWS, you have to put in the first code that you see, wait for it to expire, and then go ahead and add the second code that you see. Okay, so two consecutive MFA codes you must add. Okay, so that's how it runs. So I'll explain it again. So you're going to go ahead and set up and install your Authenticator app. Okay, then you're going to go ahead and show the QR code. get your Authenticator app open on your phone. Go ahead and scan this QR code. It's going to, of course, integrate this QR code with the Authenticator app. Then, as soon as that has been compiled, you're going to see a code appear on your phone with a token. Now, the first token that you see, okay, you want to type that here under MFA code 1. Then you're going to wait for it to expire, and then you're going to go ahead and put the second one as MFA code 2. And once you are done with that, you can go ahead and click assign MFA. Now this is going to assign it, and then you'll get a message box here saying it was successfully completed. Okay, adding MFA. So that will be the message that you'll see. Okay, so that is how you would go about setting multi-factor authentication. Okay, so I'll go back here. So once you've set it, you can actually go back to IAM once you've configured it, and then you'll notice that you'll have no more security recommendations, and this add MFA for yourself here will show as a green tick. Now be sure to go ahead and log out of here, okay, and sign in with your root account as well quickly, just to add MFA for yourself. Okay, you shouldn't use your root account again. I know I said it earlier, but since we're coming to the MFA part, this is when is the last time you should actually use it, okay? So just be sure to add MFA there as well, okay? So just be sure to do that. Okay, so yeah, that's it. So I just wanted to give you a quick introduction into multi-factor authentication AWS and guide you in the right place to setting it up. So it is a must. I would highly recommend it. So make sure you add MFA to your IAM user account and your root account. Okay, now like I said, the layout is going to be the same. Okay, it might look slightly different in the section, but it's going to be generally the same. So don't worry, it's going to be the same process. If you log into your root account, you come to IAM here, you go to add MFA, it's going to be the same. Okay, and just wait for this. And you're going to scroll down as well. You may need to scroll down a little bit further, okay, until you get to assign MFA device. Just look for this section and then assign it. And this will look exactly the same process and everything. So don't worry, it will look the same. Okay, so just bear that in mind. Okay, so that's all I have on MFA on IAM. So I hope to learn something new, and I guided you in the right direction. Okay, so that's it.